reboot!
Hey guys, I am here with a huge dose of nostalgia for me. If you can recognize these guys, you pretty much should be kind of all giddy and happy. If not, well, you obviously never watched Reboots. Reboots was a fantastic series from when I was younger. I'm talking like 95-ish. If I'm correct, this was the first fully CGI series that was out there. And I believe these guys were the ones that also made Beast Wars. I believe Mainframe, which is the company behind Reboot, also did Beast Wars. So these guys kind of came before Beast Wars. Fantastic series. Reboot basically takes place in the city of Mainframe, which is located inside of a computer. You've got characters. Here's the Series 1 figures. You've got Bob, who is a guardian sent in to pretty much destroy viruses, although Bob kind of feels different about that. You have Dot, who's also Dot Matrix, you know, the commands Dot kind of thing. Enzo, her little brother. And then the two viruses who live in Mainframe, Megabytes and Hexadecimal. You also have Megabytes to kind of lead henchmen, at least for a while. Heck and Slash, who are these guys here. Reboot takes place in the city of Mainframe, inside the computer. And when you think about it logically, it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But it's one of those kids shows where it's like, you know what, let's just go with it. The way it works is the user of the computer loads a game into Mainframe. This giant GameCube just goes and lands in a section of Mainframe. And it is the job of the sprites, who is Bob, Enzo, Dot, Frisket, who is Enzo's dog, and kind of whoever else lands in there to fight the user. My computer just got loud all of a sudden. Anyway, but it's their job to fight the user in these games. If they beat the user, nothing happens, the GameCube goes away, easy peasy. If they lose to the user, which really just makes no sense at all to me, wherever the GameCube had landed becomes kind of just a war zone. Cities destroyed, lives are lost, there are ones and zeros who live in this world. It's mayhem. Which kind of doesn't make sense because the user's playing a game. When the user wins, it's basically destroying parts of his computer. Not a lot of logic there. I don't know if you can hear the birds outside or not. But, really good series. Lasted for 3 seasons. And then they had 2 movies, which I think were like 4 episodes each. So you kind of had 4 seasons. Ended on a huge cliffhanger. But, yeah, there you go. Or I could just read the story. Here. I'm going to put this right here. So you can read this yourself, okay? Go ahead and pause that if you want. Okay, there's enough of that. So on to Hack and Slash. I'm doing these guys together because they are the exact same figure, just red and blue. Red versus blue, ha ha ha, kind of thing. Hack and Slash were made by Megabyte. Their names are kind of a pun on, games where it's like Hack, Slash, kind of like text-based games, I think, mainly. And they are kind of his henchmen. The early part of this series, they would climb onto ABCs, which are like armored binome carriers or something. And they would kind of ride into battle. They would kind of do his little dirty deeds. Although they had their morals. Often, they would question what they're doing, if it was right or not. And being that they are incredibly stupid, they would wind up forgetting their instructions, forget the mission altogether. These guys are very strong. They have tons of weaponry built into them, just not a whole lot of brains. And the only way that you can kind of beat them is to outsmart them. Incredibly strong. Bob often beats them just by outwitting them somehow. Not bad little figures. These are made by Irwin Toys. And if you remember Irwin, back when I was in middle school, so this is like, I guess the time, these guys kind of came out maybe around there, sometime around there. Irwin also did the original Dragon Ball Z figures, the figures that had no leg movements, no head movement, no torso, but they had arm movements. And they had the little plastic shell clothing. Same guys do these guys. Here's what's included. This is Hack, that is Slash. Exact same figures, they come with these little stands. Because that's how they were in the show. And obviously you can't really balance them unless you just you know, push-ups, which you could do push-ups. They come with these nice little stands, which is properly labeled figure stand support des personages, whatever that means. I can't read it. Just fits right in. They kind of clip it, which is nice, and you can kind of, you know, have them in different little variety of poses. That's about it. Articulation of these guys is kind of low. Their arms can do about this much. You can try to go further, but, you know, you're kind of limited, and they have elbows. And you can even rotate their hands. And if you want, you can even say that they have head movements. So they can do this. Now, you may notice in the back they have this giant hole. I'm not sure what purpose that would actually serve, but I do know there were later figures introduced that had the figures' jetpacks. The characters eventually in the show got jetpacks. They could fly around on their own. I don't want to spoil, you know, these guys, because I know some of you are actually watching Reboot for the first time in many years. But these guys were kind of Megabyte's henchmen, and eventually it kind of changed allegiances. You know, their morals kind of got in the way, and they were... I'm not going to spoil it. But anyway, these guys have a pretty cool, pretty interesting little gimmick. These guys are basically the Waspinators of Reboots. They could take serious damage, blown up into pieces, flattened, whatever, and they would be rebuilt very easily. The toys also have this feature. I have yet to do this perfectly the first time, so we're just going to wing it. You may notice on the instructions, apply downward pressure to pop hack apart. Watch hack pop apart, reassembles easily. Pull the end of hack's tentacle. It's a tentacle. To extend his arm, yes. They have little extendy arms, which go from here to there. So, I kind of don't really use that. I mean, that's kind of a... doesn't really do much. But anyway, onto their explodey gimmick. What you're going to do, push down on their shoulders, try to get it from the back since this is two shells, and what you should get is... explodey! His arms come off, his head shoots off, doot, 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 front body, and his other arm. So you can reenact these guys kind of, well, it's kind of cool that they actually explode. Let me try to do this again with Slash over there. So again, take him, push down, and... ah, there you go. Kind of cool little fun gimmick. Definitely something interesting. It's definitely, you know, different. Just be warned, though, these antennas definitely feel like they could snap off rather easily. But a cool little thing. And I know someone's going to ask if it is possible. I don't know why you guys ask these silly little questions. These guys are the exact same figures. But... yes, you can take their pieces and mix and match them and make your own hybrid figure. I don't know why you guys always ask me these questions. It's like the G1 Optimus Prime and Ultra Magnus thing. You guys still ask me if Prime can fit in Magnus' armor, like it's some mysterious query. But anyway, if you want to, yes, you can mix and match their limbs. They look goofy, so I don't know why you really want to do it. But you can! Still, though, cool little figures. If you were into reboots, you may want to pick these guys up. These actually go... They vary from fairly cheap to... kind of, why would you charge that much for it on the Ube? And there may be a few versions. I know there's these original ones. These are the ones from Series 1. And I know there is a version that comes with jetpacks in the back, so you may want to get those. If there are more past that, I'm not very certain. It's sad, but there's not a whole lot of information regarding Reboot toys and how many there actually are. I just know there's a lot. But that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed the review. I hope you guys like Reboot, because I definitely do plan to do more Reboot figures. I got kind of crazy recently with buying some. But there you go. Hope you enjoyed the review, and I hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.